We wanted to make sure that there was a space for everyone who was interested in spoken word, not just in performing capacity, but also people who wanted to watch. That we could have a consistent space where you know you can come to the same place every first Thursday of the month and you're going to find people who are going to be interested in listening to you and people that you're interested in listening to. We definitely encourage our members to express themselves, to express their views, their unique experiences, to, you know, as far as the First Amendment will allow them.
A girl with a shaved head and with eyes deep enough to stand in, with conviction strong enough to stand on.
Spoken word makes me feel like I'm finding the words for stuff that I cannot express. Because it sucks to just have all of these emotions like bottled up inside of you and feeling like you start to not value yourself anymore. You start to feel insignificant, like those thoughts, those feelings, those emotions don't matter. But spoken word kind of gives an avenue to expressing them. So I think it's very important.
I am an emotional creature.
We had never written anything wonderful, but we have told thousands of tales.
Like the first time you smelled the fragrance of a flower.
We see ourselves as a forum where individuals can come and figure out how to express themselves on political issues as well as personal issues in a way that's very constructive, that isn't necessarily, it's turning debate into dialogue. That's something I love about poetry. I feel like it's a space that people really feel welcome. Poetry at its best changes minds, changes people. And I think that's where the power of it comes, is taking an issue that people might view as something that's not related to them at all, and, you know, making it human.
I know it sounds cruel, but now that I think about it, what if she was just hungry?